Hi, Martin here. Today I want to show you how to replace a couple connectors for your turn signal and parking lights. I'm putting some aftermarket headlights in here, and these turn signal ones right here, the locking clips on them have broke. Now that's kind of typical out here in Las Vegas area, where it's very dry climate, low humidity, and these connectors break. And then I went down to pick apart, where I just clipped off a couple good ones here, like that, and then I'm going to show you how to remove these wires from this connector and how to replace them and remove this connector and get the connector replaced so they'll snap back on, and that way you won't have to use any plastic tie wraps or anything like that to hold them on. All right, let's get started. All right, first we need to remove this yellow piece of plastic right here. That's kind of a safety feature for the terminals. I mean, it's a redundant locking clip. Okay, slide that right out and just use a small screwdriver. Those generally do come out easier. This is like a weather seal type connector. We need to pull out this rubber grommet on the back. You just need to get it out so far. Now, the hard part. There are little locking clips in here. This one you can actually see. If you look right down there, you can see like that little piece of plastic sitting on top of the terminal. That's the clip you gotta kind of lift to unlock the terminal. So you need to get a smaller blade screwdriver, or I've got these things here I got off of Amazon. They're kind of light duty. I mean, they're almost flimsy in a way, but I've used these several times and they actually have saved me be able to get these terminals out. And it comes with a variety of different extractors on here for all kinds of different types of terminals and connectors. The ones I always use the most are like these little blade ones right here. They come in kind of handy. All right, now I've got a slide. What you want to do is grab the wire and you're going to put some tension on it, but not a lot. Just enough to pull it back once you get that locking clip lifted up. There, it released. Now these terminals only do go in one way. Now, this one and this one here are a little bit harder just because you can't see the locking clip through this little window that they provide. There we go. Now the last one. There we go. All right, now we got us a good connector. Now we just need to replace this one. Now this is one way of doing it. I'll show you right now. Pull that piece out. And since we're replacing the connector, we don't exactly have to be gentle with this one, do we? So we can just break those pieces out of there. And now we can see these little locking clips really easy. Just like that. Here, I'm gonna make it really easy to see them. There. Now you can see all three of those little locking clips right there. Now the only thing I want to do is, as I remove them, I'm gonna pull the wire out and put it directly back into the connector in the same location. That way you can ensure that you got the wiring correct. Let's get that grommet out. One of the wires is pulling out already. I may have broke the locking clip on it. And actually you could do that as well. Okay, so we know that wire there was at the very end with the connector facing just like that. go. There, locked in. Now I could simply break these locking tabs off of here and pull these connectors right out. But I just kind of want to show you that you got to lift these up and then it pull out. Actually, that one did break. So that's our second wire. Of course, this little grommet's holding the wires in order as well. There we go. All right. Got number three, two. Here's number three. There we go. Give them a little tug, make sure they're all staying in there. Put this grommet back in. Grab this little locking piece here. Push that down in there. There we go. It's been replaced. All right, now plug these in, lining up the arrows. Arrow here and arrow there. All right, I got that headlight assembly installed. All the lights are working great now, and those plugs plug right in like they should. I hope you enjoyed this video, found it helpful and informative, and if you did, I sure appreciate the thumbs up. And if you never subscribed to me before, please hit that subscribe button right down there and a little bell symbol right next to it. And I'm also an Amazon affiliate where you'll find products and tools that we may have used in this video, and you can do all your Amazon shopping through one of those links. Just check those out in the description. And that financially helps the channel out a little bit, and I sure appreciate that. Thanks again for watching, and we will see you on the next one.